Hello everybody, Laura here. So I have a scrapbook layout process video for you guys today. And I'm going to be scrapping that picture of me from off of my Snapchat with the bunny ears. And I'm going to be using my DIY scrapbooking kit that I put together. I have a video on my channel and I will try to leave that in the iCard for you to go and check out and see what all items and papers that I put together. And I think this is my second or third layout that I've created using the kit that I put together. So that 12 by 12 paper in the background, the green, I believe that is from a Heidi Swan. Okay, I don't know what happened to my recording. So like I was saying, the green paper in the back, I think is from a Heidi Swap paper pad. Or just a little pack of her papers, and I wanted it to be as a border, so I took my white cardstock, cut it down a little bit, and placed it on there, and I also cut out the center of that green paper so that I could use it in other areas of my layout. And I have this heart cut file, and I got that from Marilyn, this woman who had sent me some cut files. I had posted in Scrapaholics Anonymous on Facebook, in the Facebook group that is ran by Inky Quill, and I had just posted to see if anybody would be willing to send me any of the cut files, because I do not own any of the machines that cut those, and I love them being used in everybody's layout. So and she was generous enough to send me some, and I'm very grateful for that, because I really do love that, and I hope to get a machine soon. It is definitely on my list, just not in the budget at the moment. So I did take the green paper and that striped paper, and I'm going to be using those as my layers, photo mats for my picture, and sticking those on there. I just wanted it to all look a little cohesive. This bun is another cut file that she had sent to me, and I'm going to back that with the green paper to incorporate that. And yeah, I'm having a lot of fun scrapbooking. I still say I'm pretty new at it. I'm learning all these women who create these beautiful layouts, and it's great. So I'm taking this Hello, and that is from Crepe Paper Wonder Collection, the wood pieces, I think, or wood veneer pieces, and I'm going to paint it pink, and this is the Americana multi-surface paint in Flamingo, I believe, is the color. And just wanted to bring the pink in instead of leaving it just the straight wood. Okay, and then this cut file that says fun, that was something that was also sent to me by Marilyn, and I wanted to back it with that green paper just to continue to bring in all those colors. And I've wanted to pop up the heart on fun foam, give it some dimension, and create that shadow around it that will be on the cardstock. I really like how that looks. And just chopping all this up. It's a pretty thin foam. It doesn't have adhesive on the back, so I have to stick adhesive on both sides, but use what you got. So, and then I have these little bunny rabbits, and they are from a springtime collection. I'm not familiar, I don't remember, maybe by Pebbles. And I just thought the little bunnies were so cute, and since my Snapchat photo is me having bunny ears on, I thought it fit pretty well. And I wanted the word fun to also be popped up so that it could lay it on the heart, so that the title kind of all went together. And which I wanted the hello, instead of it being a element all on its own, I decided to fit it in for the title, so it just would be hello fun times. And I have the alphas that I will use here in a second for the word times. And I kept taking these doilies and trying to decide if I wanted it to be behind the picture or not. But I think it looked okay, but I feel like it was just maybe adding just a little too much up there. So here's the word times, and those are by Recollections, and they look like cardboard, like corrugated word or letters. And I really like those, and they have really good adhesive on the back of them, so I didn't have to add extra glue or anything. And then that camera down in the bottom right hand corner is from Chamel. It's these cork pieces, and I've had those for a really long time, and I keep trying to use them, but so far I've only used just a couple of pieces. And these stickers are from a set that came from the Dollar Tree. I believe they had them last year sometime. And I'm just going to add those pieces, the little chevron pieces. I wanted it to be as long as the word times, and so I grabbed another one, and I realized I really didn't have any other yellow on the page, so I switched out the yellow pieces and just added a couple of the blues and darker pink, and that way it extends the whole length of the word times. And I'm just going to start gluing everything down. That corkboard or the cork sticker was adhered already really good, so it's got really good adhesive on it as well. And just start sticking everything down, placing it where I think it looks good. I decided the picture off to itself. Everything kind of went at a diagonal, and the picture was off over by itself, but I like the way that that looked, so I think it was okay to do that. And let's see what else I'm going to add here. Oh, I have these flowers that also came from Dollar Tree, and I bought several packs of those when they came out. And so I put one up on the heart, and then I also have this DIY flare embellishment, and I have a video on my YouTube channel where I created those, and I'll try to leave that in an iCard as well. You can go check those out. They're really easy to make. And I decided my photo just needed a little bit extra, so I decided to go on ahead and add another little bit of layer of this green paper behind it. I just felt it looked more cohesive that way. And then I'm going to take some, their little cork stick, cork stars, and those are from DIY shop, I think. I'm not real sure. If you go back and watch that scrapbook kit that I put together, I am more in detail about all the products that went into this kit. So if you're wondering about something, maybe you could go check that out. Oh, AC American Crafts. Do it yourself, yeah. So I'm just going to stick those around the page, just add some little sprinkles kind of with them. Excuse me. And I've also got this little cup where I went and took a bunch of glitter papers, and I have all different colors of glitter paper, and I punched out a bunch of stars. I have one little bowl that has stars in it, one little bowl with hearts, and another little bowl with little bows in it. So I decided to add the gold stars, and I feel like those go in there, even though I don't really have any other gold on the page other than, well, I wanted to bring it in because the DIY flare embellishment that I added at the bottom had the gold heart, so I wanted to bring in more gold around the page. And I also decided to add some gold sequins and just kind of sprinkle those around. And then I'm going to take, I have some of my homemade ink sprays, and that's the Cameo Pink, which I keep with my, this kit, so that, because I felt like that pink really matched with the colors for the kit. And I'm going to sprinkle that around a little bit. And then I also take out my DIY Shimmer Mist in gold, and sprinkled that around the page. But whenever I was trying to sprinkle it out, a big blob of it fell out from the lid. Here in a second, you'll see it. You won't see it happen, but I'll show, because unfortunately, I realized that the bottom half of the page is kind of off screen, so I apologize for that. But I dropped a big blob of it, so I decided to add another one of the flowers from Dollar Tree just to cover it up. And I had to move that star around. But after that, it will pretty much finish up my page. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope that maybe you've gained some inspiration for this and you really like how it's put together. So I will talk to you guys later. I don't have any pictures at the end, unfortunately. I'm sorry. I took the pictures, but they're not wanting to export from my computer onto this video. So I apologize. So thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you later. Bye.